Okay. He asked, when Enoch walked with God, what does that mean? Can we walk with God? How do we do that? And I just want to show you two quick Bible verses, if that's okay to answer this really quick, because I know the next question I can answer really quick too. So we'll do this really quick if that's okay. The verse you're referring to as far as Enoch walking with God is Genesis chapter 5 and verse 24, where it says, and Enoch walked with God and he was not, for God took him. And that always was an interesting verse for me because I was like, he walked with God and then he was no more because God took him. So it's like, you know, something having to do with this walk that Enoch had with God allowed him to be translated to heaven before he even died. And that's really a cool thought to think, you know, and I do believe there's only two people that I know of, at least that it speaks about in the Old Testament. I guess actually there's more, but that Enoch who never saw death and was translated to heaven. And then you see Elijah who also never saw death, but was translated to heaven. But then Moses who did die, but then was later translated to heaven. And I do believe that these people represent the people at the end of time. Those who never saw death and are translated, those represent the people at the end of time that when Jesus comes, they're going to go straight to heaven. They don't have to see death. And so I think that's pretty cool. And yes, we can be those people today. That is what God is calling us to do today. That's actually the purpose of his special people at the end of time, the 144,000 that you read about in Revelation chapter 7 and verse 14, and Revelation 7 and in chapter 14 as well. Now, how do we have this walk like Enoch? Go with me to Hebrews chapter 11, and I'm just going to read these two verses, and then that'll be it. But basically, it sums it up right here. Hebrews chapter 11 and verses 5 and 6, and it says, by faith, Enoch was taken away so that he did not see death and was not found because God had taken him. For before he was taken, he had this testimony that he pleased God. So to walk with God is to live in such a way that we please God. Okay, but what does that mean? And it goes on in verse 6 to say, but without faith, it is impossible to please him. For he who comes to God must believe that he is and that he is a rewarder of those who diligently seek him. So this walk that Enoch had with God was one where he sought God on a daily basis, continually in every aspect of his life. He was in continual connection with God and seeking God's will, seeking his face, seeking whatever it was that would please God. And he would do it by faith. And, you know, a lot of times we go, well, what does that mean to do something by faith or live by faith? You know, it says, the Bible says the just shall live by faith. And really and truly, where I see it, you know, coming into practice is in just day-to-day life and the decisions that we make. And the way we know whether or not we're making the right decision is ultimately based on, you know, are we following God's word? Are we following his truth? Are we following his commandments? And, you know, you see this as, you know, maybe you're at work and a situation comes up where, you know, you're faced with having to tell the truth and it might not be in your favor to do that, but you have to be honest and in a loving way, and you have to speak the truth, or you have to not steal. Maybe you're coming short in finances, but you have to live an honest life and say, God, I won't steal, even though, you know, it's not in my favor, you know, to do that, but I'm going to live an honest life and I'm going to please God and I'm going to put God first. I'm going to obey his commandments. I'm going to keep the Sabbath day holy, the seventh day Sabbath, he says in his fourth commandment. You know, that might not be in my favor, you know, in my job, but by faith, I'm going to keep it. And by faith, I'm going to see that God will bless me despite, you know, what the world might think otherwise. And so it's by faith that we obey his commandments and we choose what is right. In every aspect of our lives, you know, God says, thou shalt not covet. We're supposed to start, this obedience in our heart that we only long for what God wants for us and not, long for other things outside of his will. And so I really see that that's really the walk that Enoch had. He desired to please God and he would do whatever it took in order to, live by faith and obey God and, you know, in such a way that somebody once put it so beautifully that he walked so far with God that his character was so much like him that he was actually closer to heaven than earth. And it just made sense for him to just go there because it was like he was already living in heaven because he was so close to his Father in heaven. So I hope that's an answer. I'm sorry if it took a little bit longer, but that's what I would say.
Yeah, you hit all the main points there. Yeah, like it's about faith. It's about keeping the word, staying in truth. But I have to say, this is one of my favorite. I always say that about everything, right? But I really started noticing this is a common theme in the Bible. Throughout the Bible, it's talking about walk, 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 path, 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 feet, mm-hmm. feet, 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 feet. Like there's this common theme throughout the whole Bible. And so I've like myself put together a whole set of Bible studies just on this topic. Mm-hmm. And it's just so amazing how if you stitch them all together, you really do get like a full picture of the gospel just studying this one theme. And it is... encompasses everything Tina just said.
Mm-hmm. Well, you'll have to give us that Bible study, like just on a side video or something, because I think that would be great. I would love to see that. That sounds awesome.
That's great. All right.
Thank you, Bob. Great question. Yes, thank you.